Alright guys, welcome to today's show. So, today we are gonna talk about AND gates. And we have touched upon this subject a little bit. So, just to rehearse a little bit, it looks like this, the symbol for an AND gate, if we're doing an electronic sketch. So we have two inputs, A and B, and we have one output. So the inputs are either 0 or 1, and if both A and B are 1, then the result is 1, otherwise 0. Okay, so this far everything is pretty clear, but how do we construct such a circuit? The idea here is that we're gonna try to make a sketch first and then build this and see if we can make it work. Okay, so what we need to use here are two transistors. And as you may remember, the transistor it works like a switch. So if we put electricity on the center leg, then it will let electricity pass from the left to the right leg. So we need two of these. We need one or several resistors. And then we have a battery. And then we have a lamp, an LED light. And that looks something like this. So with the help of these components, we are trying to build something that works like an AND gate. Okay, so if you want, you may pause the video now and pick up a piece of paper and a pen, if you don't have a blackboard at home. And see if you can puzzle this together and see if you can make it work. Then we will continue in 5 seconds. Alright guys, so I'm thinking of design something along these lines. So let's begin here with a battery. And let's put in a resistor, so we don't push too much electricity through this light that I have here. And this is a regular LED light. So this will indicate that our output is a 1. So we could, for instance, put the output here on its own line if we were to use it for something else. Okay, so let's first go through the path that this light will use in order to light up. So first, we go through our first transistor. So, something like... something like this. So this is the left leg, this is the right leg. and this right here is the middle leg and also the A input. And the left leg is also called collector, the right leg is called emitter, and the middle leg is called the bass. But I will talk in the lines of left and right, middle leg. It's easier to understand, at least for beginners, I think. All right, so now we come to the second one. And we connect these two in series. Then we will go down here to the battery. So something like this, but we need to add one thing, because if we push electricity through this first one, we want it to activate this transistor, but the electricity must go through here in order for the A to activate, which means that the A cannot activate unless B is already activated. So I would like to put another line here through a resistor like this, and I want this resistor to be bigger than this one. So let's say this is a 1K resistor, this is a 100 ohm resistor. Because now if we activate this A input, which we do by connecting this to the plus side. So let's see, let's connect it like this. So this is the plus side of the battery, and this is the minus side. So when we have connected this A input, the electricity will flow from the battery through this transistor and down here through this path here, which means this transistor will turn on. And that will make electricity flow through this light, through this transistor, and stop here. Okay, so that's the first input. What about the B input? Well, we need to connect that as well. So let's first try something like this. So if we do it like this, then the electricity will go this direction here, and since there's not any resistor here, it will follow through this path right here. And even if this other one is disconnected, this path will still work. And in this case, this transistor will turn on, which will push electricity maybe we should add a resistor here as well. Otherwise, this path will be a short circuit, which is not good. So let's put in one here as well, and let this be 1K. So electricity will still flow through this and around here. Yeah. And this will activate both of these transistors, which will push electricity through this first small resistor through this LED. It will go through the first transistor, second transistor, and this light will light up. So this is the general idea, the general design, and let's hope that this works, because now we are going to try to build this thing. Okay then, so let's start with this 100k resistor, and let's connect this to the plus side. So we'll start from the bottom left of the sketch and go through the same way that I draw it before. So we will take the outer path first, the one that the electricity for the light will take, and then we will take the inputs. Let's see here. So we'll start by connecting this LED light, and remember to put the long leg on the plus side, so something like this. So if we were to use this as an output, we could connect a jumper cable like this and use it for something else. But I will not do that now. Alright, so from the light we want to put in our first transistor. And these are NPN type transistors. And there is two different kinds, so make sure to use the correct one. I will describe this more thoroughly at a later point. Alright, and then we will connect the second one in series with the first, which means that these two will be on the same line. So as you can see, they are the right leg of the first is connected to the same line as the left leg of the second, which means that these two are connected together. All right, so what did we have more? I think we had the, let's see here. We need a connection to the negative side. So we will continue connecting these in series here. So we'll take this and connect it to ground. So the ground is the minus side, the blue side. Like so. And now we have the entire path for the LED light. Now we need to connect the rest of the circuit. Let's see, we wanted to have one of these 1K resistors connected in parallel with these. So the same line that contains legs from both of these transistors, there I want to put in this resistor connecting directly to the minus side. All right. And now we can put in one of these jumper cables, which will be the A input. So let's connect it to the center leg of this here. So if we connect this directly to the plus side, this should activate. So we'll just let it float here for now. Okay, but the second leg we want to move through a resistor. So let's do that. Let's see here. Yes. So in series with the center leg of the second transistor, I'm going to connect this resistor, 1K resistor. Something like this. And then I connect the B input to the leg of this transistor. And this should be everything. So if I have designed this the correct way, it should probably work. So let's connect these batteries. So it's around 3 volts. And it doesn't really matter where I connect it as long as the plus and minus side are correct, because I have linked these two sides together. So let's start with the red one, which is the A input. Let's connect it to 3 volts. And as we can see, nothing is happening. And let's put it back here. And let's see what happens if we connect the B input. Still nothing. What if we connect both of these? Let's see here. Did I connect everything? All right, so I finally figured it out. What I did was I moved this resistor from here to here. And currently, it doesn't light up. If we connect one of the inputs, still nothing. If we connect both of the inputs and we go through these resistors, now it works. So basically, the changes I made we have this resistor going there. We removed this right here. And instead, put the 1K resistor here. And remove this connection and go there. So when these two are activated through these 1K resistors, so there's one resistor here and one here, that means that we can go through this whole circuit and it works. So I hope you liked this episode. Please like and subscribe. And thanks for watching. Thanks for today.